Hey there. Welcome to video four. It's Dana Damara. Thank you so much for continuing to tune in. Okay, this next video is sacred tools that you can use for connection, a deeper connection to the divine. And again, these are not necessary, although they are really fun when you really start playing around with them. So we've talked about our altar and how to set it up. The next thing I want to tell you a little bit about are these crystals that I have at the altar. So, truth be told, these crystals, these bigger ones, don't sit at my altar. They actually sit around my house. But I thought for video purposes, I could share them with you and you could just kind of understand each one's properties. And these are basic. I'm just going to give you like my top favorite, right? This is an amethyst. So my dream is to have, you know, an amethyst like this big in my house. I just love it. I'm going to have an amethyst in my house that big. But for now, this little guy does amazing things. It's very healing, very protective, very divinely connected. And when you're choosing crystals or mala beads or anything like that, you always want to feel it and just see how it feels for you. This one spoke to me the second I touched it. And when you are purchasing crystals too, my invitation to you is to find a place that you energetically feel really good at. So when I lived in Washington State, I went to a place called Celestial Awakenings, and still talk to those people. Just the connection there is deep, rooted. I was bringing my daughters in there when they were like four, and they would run their hands over the crystals and go, "Oh, I want this one, I want this one." So. Be four when you pick out a crystal. Now I go to a place in the Castro, right across from Yoga Tree Castro, the little Tibetan shop, and always, everything I get is from there. Love her. So this is amethyst, very protective. You can put it around your house. I have little ones that I put in my pillow, and it helps to promote good dreams. Also have the quartz. I love this quartz. This quartz is amazing. I know you can't see it because I don't have the video set where I can hone in on you, but it's just such a beautiful design, and it's a little crooked on the bottom, which I find lovely, because sometimes we're all a little crooked on the bottom now, aren't we? So I mean, this little guy up right there. And then I have citrine. And I actually have the little, most crystal shops will give you a little write-up. If they don't, just ask them. Say, "Do you have a write-up for this?" They'll give one to you. And citrine is really cool. I'm going to read it to you. It's for first, second, and third chakra. Excellent stone for artists or individuals seeking to discover the artistic outlet within themselves. Awakening the powers of creative imagination. So citrine is a really beautiful, beautiful energy. Wow, I can actually feel this little guy vibrating in my hand. And then I also have aragonite star clusters. It's so beautiful. And you can get these in all different shapes. And sometimes little pieces will fall off. It's okay, right? So I would probably take that and just give it to Shakti when that happens. This promotes focus and concentration and can be helpful for students and can be helpful for meditation. So sometimes if I'm feeling scattered, which happens, it happens to all of us. Human, hello. I put this in my hand when I'm meditating and just drop into the energy of the crystal, right? So I have that one at my altar all the time. And then again, I mentioned this in another video, rose quartz. Rose quartz is so powerful. You can grid your car with rose quartz. It'll help to keep you safe. It really works. And I've given my daughters rose quartz to wear. And they get it. Your kids get it. It's never too early to offer your kids crystals. Just make sure they can't swallow them if they're little. And then the other thing I like to have is sage or Palo Santo. I talked about this in a couple videos. Obviously, I'm very much into it. It's old ritual every morning, every night, anytime before I have a full moon ceremony at my house. Anybody that walks in the door gets saged and Palo Santos. to do that, you can just stand up and the person will do your crown chakra, and your third eye, your heart, all the way down to your feet. They'll do your feet, they'll do your hands, your armpits, and just cleansing the energy. I do this in my house. I do it every day when I get home because I'm around a lot of people. And honestly, I think I can notice a difference when I don't. So definitely, again, I mentioned it a couple times, but put it in something. The other thing I like to use is essential oils. Those of you who know me, you know that essential oils is a big part of my life. Again, sandalwood every morning on my third eye. Every morning, it's just the way it is. I actually keep it on my altar so I don't forget. And then I'm gonna share with you a few of my favorite ones. Lavender, again, drop into the hand, fourth finger, third eye, rub hands together, smile. Three times. When you smell, make sure the smell goes through the sinuses down into the very back of the brain. And you want to do that three times so that that essence of scent is infiltrating your nervous system. Lavender is very calming, very calming. You can put the oils on your bottoms of your feet as well, or the wrists or the back of the neck. Those are the places where you're going to experience these the most. Frankincense is my other favorite. It's very, very, very grounding. Extremely grounding. So anytime I'm feeling like, oh my gosh, I have to get really grounded today, which is every day, third eye, back of my neck, smell three times on my feet. Basically ritual every morning, actually. And then here's a couple other ones. Cedarwood. Cedarwood is really, really, really good for ancestral healing. So if you've got, I don't know, maybe some old patterns that you'd like to be free from, cedarwood helps. Now, do remember that when you ask for healing and you start using things like this and you start dropping in, that things aren't gonna magically disappear, like, oh, I want ancestral healing. And then poof, it's gone. No, what happens is it brings it up. So it's gonna bring it up to the surface, so it might get harder before it gets easier. Which is fine, you can handle that, right? Elevation, joy. This is like, this just makes me happy to smell this. This just makes me happy. Sometimes I'll rub it on my chest, I'll rub it on my feet, on my wrist. And then Intune. This is just a special blend by doTERRA. And honestly, I don't have my glasses, so I can't read this in this moment to tell you exactly what's in it, but I use this almost every day to stay focused because I have a tendency to get distracted. Super easy. I don't get distracted by social media and stuff, but I get distracted by all these creative things that go on in my mind, and I wanna do this, I wanna do this, I wanna go here, I wanna go there. And so Intune helps. And then Yiling Yilang, and I know that's not how you pronounce it, but that's how I like to pronounce it, for the heart. This is heart chakra. There's also a blend by doTERRA called Digest Zen, and I use that every day too. These are my favorite ones that I use every day. And essential oils, you know, there's so much toxicity in our world that we have no control over. And so I have been using essential oils for a few years now, religiously trying to get rid of the toxic load in my house, in my family, in my children. And my goal is to get them to reach for the essential oils before they reach for anything else. It's just a powerful way to heal. And then the other thing is I have this and many deck of cards. They're not tarot cards, but these were made by a friend of mine, Tosha Silver. Some of you know the story with Tosha Silver, but she is an amazing astrologist. I love her dearly, and she came to my yoga class one time, and I didn't even know it was her. So, and I quoted her, which was amazing. So she created these awesome deck of cards, and I have multiple cards at my altar, and I use them quite frequently, actually. And so you can just shuffle them, and let's say you need something for the day, right? You just kind of hang out with your cards for a second. You ask a question, knock three times. Remember that song? Knock three times on the ceiling if you want me. You're going to think of that every time now. Knock three times, asking the question, and then flip the card over. And this one is evolution. And so that might be your word for the day, right?
That's kind of cool,
actually. I'll just put that right there, and then that's kind of in your little heart and energy. And then, let's see, the other thing is, you can't really see this, but don't worry, I'm gonna teach a class on it soon. Sacred geometry is very important to me. Very, very, very important to me. And I continue to learn so much about sacred geometry and how important it is in our lives. And this in particular is a grid. And this is a grid on Metatron's cube. And I have a crystal on each point that have been moon bathed. And then there's a stone. I don't remember the name of this stone, but it's for root chakra. And then three tiger eyes, which is solar plexus around it. And then all the crystals around the grid. And this just amplifies energy. And when you start to play with sacred geometry, you start to realize that your life is really, really epic and powerful and in patterns. And you're not on a linear line at all. You're in a beautiful spiral that continues to bring you to a higher state of who you are, if you're open to it. So this sits at my altar. I think that's it. Yeah, those are my favorite sacred tools. And again, you don't need them. You don't need them, right? They're just fun to have. You know, actually, I did forget one that's really important that I want to say with regard to the crystals. First of all, I wear these crystals all the time on my wrists, and they change, and they all mean something. So they're not meant to look pretty, although they do, but they're meant, they have certain properties. So make sure you know what you're wearing, right? And then this is a set of mala beads, right? Best for last, apparently. 108 of them on here. Just like the rosary. And other religions, I'm sure, have something like this. I'm most familiar with mala beads and rosary. So this 108 time chanting, right? Why 108? What's so important about 108? Well, I could tell you to Google it, but I'll give you the cliff notes, okay? 8 plus 1 is 9. Very auspicious number. Why? Well, there's 9 planets and 12 zodiac signs, right? 9 times 12 is 108. So, mathematicians and astrologists and Vedic mystics from forever and ages ago have gauged everything by the number 9 or the number 108, acknowledging that these are cycles in our life. Very powerful to understand that the planets, when they all get done moving in their cycle, it's the end of a cycle. It's a 9-year cycle. So we move in cycles, just like the planets. 108, plus the guru bead at the end. So when we're chanting or we're reciting mantra with the mala beads, we're invoking the divine with the, whatever the crystal is, with the breath, with the silence, with the ritual, and now with the words. Highest source of energy is vibration. So be aware of what's coming out of your mouth when you're using the mala beads. Yeah. I think that's it for sure now. So yeah, you don't need any of these things, but they're really nice to have. So maybe just go and get a mala bead, a set of mala beads, right? Sandalwood, and just give it a try, see what happens. Again, if you want to get a hold of me, I'm super accessible, dana@danadamara.com. And would love to chat with you. Yeah, so grateful that you've taken the time to watch these videos and understand a little deeper meaning of how amazing you are. Thank you so much, you guys. Have an incredible rest of your day. Namaste.